Hey, Gary.
Hi, Chris.
You got time for some questions?
Sure.
So how long have you worked at CST?
I've been here for about 16 years.
What's kept you at CST all these years?
I really enjoy what I do. I've been able to develop antibodies in a number of different signaling pathways, including cell death, and those products have been used in the research community. It's quite gratifying.
How many antibodies have you developed?
About 750.
Whew. If you chose a different career, what do you think you might be doing right now?
I considered a career in medicine, but after college, I took a job on the bench, and I really enjoyed the research there, so I decided to stay.
What do you think makes CST antibodies different from others?
I think the level of validation that we put into the antibodies, and we also get to work on a lot of different post-translational modifications that are important for understanding cell signaling.
What inspires you as a scientist?
I think just to do good work, try to make a difference for the research community.
All right, wet transfer or semi-dry transfer?
Do a wet, semi-dry transfer. So much faster.
Which of your products are you most proud of and why?
I'm really proud of some of the antibodies I made in autophagy and programmed necrosis, like some of the UOK signaling, some of the proteins like phospho-Rip kinase involved in necroptosis, for instance.
How did you first get interested in cell death?
I started working in cell death back in grad school about 30 years ago, looking at gene regulation associated with neurodegeneration.
How have you seen cell death research develop over time?
Well, lately there's been a lot more interest in non-apoptotic cell death pathways like autophagy and programmed necrosis like necroptosis and pyroptosis.
Is it true that they call you Dr. Cell Death?
Absolutely. After 30 years, Dr. Cell Death.
What do you see as the future of cell death research?
So there's definitely a lot of interest in these non-apoptotic cell death pathways. There's a clear need for reliable assays and biomarkers to enable translational research.
What's the most scientifically impactful product you've ever released?
Probably the phospho-UOK, phospho-Rip kinase antibodies. They've had a tremendous impact in understanding autophagy and necroptosis.
What's the most challenging target you ever had to design an antibody for?
The phospho-UOK and phospho-Rip kinases, they were gratifying, but they were also really challenging. We didn't have a lot of information to understand how those signaling mechanisms worked. But working with leaders in the field, we were able to get those antibodies out, and they've had a tremendous impact on the research community.
All right, this is a big one. Red Sox or Yankees?
Go Yankees.
What's the most helpful piece of advice you've received during your career?
I would say to know how to prioritize, stay focused, and to try to have an impact in whatever you do.
And what advice do you give to young aspiring scientists?
I would say keep learning, take advantage of all the knowledgeable people that you have around you, and continue to learn.
All right, thanks, Gary.
Thanks, Chris.